What you got there, Joes?
Well, it's a dandelion leaf. Found it outside. And it's food. See, the dandelion leaf is edible, and I think I'm gonna put it in my salad later.
You're hungry, aren't you?
Mm-hmm. You'd be surprised how many plants have edible parts. That's what we explore in the Food from Plants kit. The kids learn about different plant parts and the different plants that food comes from.
So this is like a weed-eating kit? The kids go outside and they eat weeds?
No, Kevin, it's not a weed-eating kit. The kids don't eat anything they find outside. All of the food that kids eat is provided in the kit. The learning goal of the kit is that most food comes from plants, like carrots, or cilantro, or corn chips.
And fish. I mean, fish aren't plants, but fish eat plants, or else they eat some kind of animal that eats plants. Just about any food that we eat, if you go back far enough, comes from plants.
You know, Kev, all this talk about food is making me hungry.
Yeah, you're always hungry, aren't you?
Stop it. In session one, you start by reviewing this plant parts poster so the kids are familiar with these six different parts of plants.
Then the children go outside for a scavenger hunt. They try to find these plant parts by finding the things that are on their scavenger hunt checklist.
Afterwards, the kids taste these two mystery foods and discuss them. Here, Kev, try one.
That's weird. It tastes kind of like potato.
But it's not. It's actually a water chestnut.
Next, the kids try to guess what plant part they're from. These water chestnuts look kind of like nuts.
But they're not.
Because you prepare and taste food in the Food for Plants kit, remember these important rules. Anybody who touches food during the session should wash their hands or use hand sanitizer before touching food. And after-school leaders should wear gloves when preparing food for the activities.
Be aware of children's food sensitivities or allergies, and don't require children to taste any foods they don't want to taste.
In session two, the kids explore what plant parts are in some foods.
During Engage, they do an activity in which kids are given a question, and they think about it, and then stand under one of these signs, which you post on the wall, for the answer that they choose.
The question here is, what plant part do you think crackers are mostly made from?
So let's say I'm a kid, and I stand under the roots sign.
Then the kids do some activities. They taste foods. They also read these How It's Made sheets to learn about what's in the foods and how they're made.
And when they go and stand by the signs again, they get a chance to either keep or change their answer. So, Kev, what's in these?
It's mostly water, flour, and salt. Tastes pretty good, huh?
Yeah.
And the flour is made from grains, which are a type of seed. In session three, pairs of kids make hummus, a tasty dip made from chickpeas, otherwise known as garbanzo beans, which are another type of seed.
I love hummus.
Mm. Hummus.
Yeah, hummus.
Each pair of kids mashes up 5 spoonfuls of chickpeas in a bag to make the hummus. Make sure the kids press the air out of the bag before mashing it, or else it might pop.
Then the children decide what spices to add to their hummus. Before the session, prepare spice plates for groups of children to share. The children then record the recipes they invent on their My Hummus recipe sheet.
In session four, the kids put everything they've learned together as they design gardens by placing plant stickers like these on their garden maps.
They think about what plants they like to eat and then read about the conditions these plants need to grow well. They use this information to help them lay out their gardens.
The kids can draw in any other things they want in their gardens, like other plants, a bird bath, or a water hose. The kids then share and discuss their gardens with the rest of the group.
The Food from Plants kit is completely nut-free and vegetarian. The handbook includes a letter for you to send home with kids to their families to find out if the kids have any food allergies, dietary restrictions, or other food sensitivities.
I love this kit. It's delicious.
Funding provided by Oracle, the Noyce Foundation, the S.D. Bechtel Jr. Foundation, the David and Lucille Packard Foundation, and the Stephen Bechtel Fund.